Hello, ladies, gentlemen, and unicorns. Let's talk chromatic aberration. So what the hell is chromatic aberration? Well, I think we've all seen it in some way or another, but not all of us might have noticed it. So I have here an image from a 3D engine, but if we look closer at it and zoom in, we notice this kind of color fringing. And that is called chromatic aberration. And let's have a look at why this happens and why we care so much in computer graphics and games, and why this is oftentimes done wrong or overdone, and how to do it correctly. So first, I have here a nice little diagram from Wikipedia. Let's zoom this one up here. And this is a lens shown from the side or from the top. And this is, of course, the center of the lens. And imagine now here, where all those wavelengths cross over each other, this is the focal plane. This is where the focus of this lens is. You would have on this plane here your film or your chip of a camera. Chromatic aberration now often happens on cheaper lenses or wide-angled lenses, which means that the different wavelengths get separated differently. They have a different focal length. So as we know, white light consists of the whole color spectrum. And if you shoot it through a prism, it just splits up into its compounding wavelengths of light. So the further away we move on a cheap lens from the center point, doesn't matter if it's up or down or left or right, the more this splitting up of the wavelengths happens. And this means that blue here has a different focal point than red in the red channel. This is essentially chromatic aberration. So this one is here from Wikipedia, and it looks like the lower one is taken with a pretty cheap lens. Pretty obvious how the light is split up, especially visible on the edges. So doesn't Unity have some kind of chromatic aberration effect? Yes, it does. And yes, it sucks. So I have here a little demo project just to show you the effect. All we need to do is we import now here the image effects. Here, this vignette and chromatic aberration. I've already done this. Just slap it on. So let's try this for us, vignette and chromatic aberration. And we have here now the chromatic aberration in simple. And as you can see, if I turn this value up and down, what it does, it applies some kind of spherical transformations so that it's like the lens is curved differently only for the green channel. And this gives this purple-green fringing. I'm not a fan of purple-green fringing because for one thing, it's not correct. And for another thing, it looks like what you have with early video camcorders and cheap lenses. So they tend to go towards a green and purple. Even the advanced setting doesn't help us very much in terms of correctness or visual fidelity. I mean, we have here these great labels such as tangential aberration, but in principle, this also means if we just look here closely, this just means that bright surfaces burn out towards green. And so this is not correct, and this is not what we want. But why do we care? Why do I care? Why is it so important for next-gen graphics? As I said, it's a hallmark of bad lenses. Why do we want our images to appear as if they were shot with bad lenses? Well, I think it has to do with making our simulated images, our fake images, appear as realistic as possible. And for this, we try also to mimic all the imperfections from the real world. We don't want something that's perfect. We want something that looks, well, imperfect, just like in reality. And this also extends to cameras. Remember the first artifact that was recreated? The big old lens flare. In the mid-90s, at the end of the 90s, any game there was a big old lens flare. In photography, you don't want lens flares unless it's an artistic decision. Then there's bloom. Remember the first time HDR rendering came out, or even before that, and everything was just bloomy in some games and it was just horrible to look at? So it's also an artifact you want to avoid. Same thing with chromatic aberration. And for that matter, same thing with film grain. So all these imperfections we keep layering on top of our digital images to make them appear as if they were shot with an analog camera and with all the trappings of shooting on analog film. So is this bad? Depends. if you do it without rhyme or reason and just slap it on for the effect, basically, and have bloom there and chromatic aberration and film grain and whatnot, well, it probably looks over the top because it is. But there are good examples where you actually want this filmic look. An example that comes to mind is Alien Isolation. This game does everything to convince you that it was shot as a movie in the 1970s on anamorphic lenses, just like the original Alien film. And for this, it just works perfectly. Tell me what you think about this video. Next time I thought I'd make another video to show you how to do this in Photoshop. And if you find that interesting, I might go into detail about how to make a shader you can use in Unity. It's not the best shader that I've come up with. It's pretty expensive, but it's very straightforward. So if you're interested, please let me know and then I'll make another video. So thanks for watching.